Okay, so I just wanted to go over this one tool that I've been using with him. I didn't think that I'd be using it indefinitely, but I've just had a much better reaction from him using it. He responds to it much better than just the slip lead that I normally use with my dogs. And I don't know what he wears in. I haven't seen him come in or leave, so I'm assuming it's a harness. With the slip lead, I know that he pushes into it to the point where he can get a little bit of a cough going, and we want to be really careful with that with these smush-faced dogs. As you know, they can get overheated, overexhausted pretty easily. So I use this LaProng collar, super little tiny guy on him. What this does is it just creates a little bit more motivation to listen because it's new information. It's something that he feels. He's much more aware of it through a little bit of discomfort, not pain, but discomfort. He is much more mindful of it, and I found that I can apply significantly less pressure with this and get a better result than much more pressure with less of a response with the slip lead and with the harness, just because the harness used to like whatever I blow this off. So, to take this on and off, you are going to want to push up. You want to take it apart, but you never want to slide it over a space or anything like that. So you're always going to take it apart. So you're just gonna push up on one of these little tines right here. And I kind of do a pinch motion with my thumb on that little circly loop to until I get those arches up. And then I'll grab those with my other hand, squeeze, and then pop out like so. And then you will wrap it around his neck. And then you will match the prongs back into those little holes and slip them in like that. Oops. This should never be left on unsupervised. I like for it to be something where we're taking for a walk, we're working on behaviors in the home, things like that. It's a very much in the moment tool just for safety. I don't want it to get caught on furniture or snagged on his crate or anything like that. When we go over the e-collar, I can't remember if I go over this in the video, but that is something that I like for him to wear much more regularly, for purpose of always being able to manage wanted behaviors. So you're not missing moment in times because he regularly has it on. You always have the ability to communicate with him regardless of where he is in the household. For this video, these videos, I'm going to have both of these on. You certainly don't need to do that. He doesn't have a lot of neck space. I found that it is pretty tricky to have both on. But when I do have them on, I will put the prong collar closest to his ears and then the e-collar back behind that. I will put the collar on much snugger at first, so it's almost gonna be feel like it's too tight, and then I just maneuver it around because he's got a little neck skin and he doesn't have a lot of space to work with. So I want it to be tighter to make sure that the e-collar prongs are making contact to his skin. But we want to make sure that's hitting fairly consistently so that you know that he's able to feel whatever the e-collar gives off. You should be able to move the box if you need to, but it should not just be sliding around easily. I like to be able to fit two fingers snugly under the strap part. But again, the box needs to be snugly on there so that it is making consistent contact to his neck. Hi, cannoli.